The American Kestrel is the smallest and one of the most common falcons in North America, but being small has its challenges. Kestrels are prey for larger raptors, and the grassland habitats where they nest are often taken for building and housing developments. The Kestrel Nest Box Project is an effort to help boost their chances of adding to the next generation. And last season's box project was the most successful to date. Producer Dave Fraser shares the story.
The American Kestrel is the North America's smallest falcon. It's a kind of hawk. It's about the size of a mourning dove. They're a very lovely little colorful bird. You might see them hovering over fields or sitting on power lines. They're peculiar for hawks in North America because they actually nest in cavities. They may nest in natural tree cavities in some cases, but in a lot of cases, tree cavities in fields are not really widely available. So what the Kestrel Trust is doing, in collaboration with both Fish and Wildlife Service and also partners with the state Fish and Game, is they're establishing and maintaining nesting boxes for kestrels. And these provide suitable nesting habitat where the kestrels can lay their eggs and raise their young in security.
When the opportunity to work on this project and work to conserve kestrels came up, we really latched onto it because obviously it's our namesake species. And it's an amazingly beautiful little bird. So for us, it's a win-win project because not only are we helping a particular species on protected lands in the area that we had a role in protecting, but we also get to work with a lot of great partners in the area who are engaged in the same kind of work, and also get to involve the community in a project that's very exciting and rewarding for them.
This is one of our kestrel boxes, which was made for us by a volunteer. We have a hole size that's specified for the particular species of bird that we want to attract, because they seem to have a requirement for that. We have a way to look into the box here. We remove this nail and open the side panel so that we can access it for checking the nest and checking the nest contents, and then in the fall, we clean out the boxes every year to get fresh material in them. I came to the valley to go to UMass and never left the area. Very quickly fell in love with the landscape. And I've always been interested in birds. So seeing the opportunity to be involved with a critical corner of bird conservation with reference to the grassland birds is personally very important to me. But it's also allowed me to put a skill that I've learned, the bird banding, to use locally. The band as issued by the government has 9 digits on it, which would be very difficult to read. So we also have permission to use a field readable band, which in this case involves colors and only 2 digits. So that allows us to keep track of these birds over their lifetimes. It will allow us to keep track of how old they become, how long they live, where they migrate, and things of that kind.
Kestrels have actually been undergoing long-term declines for decades now. And so New England, I think the New England population is actually declining at the greatest rate. And we think a lot of it has to do with the continued disappearance of suitable grassland habitat. Now the kestrels are migratory. They leave New England during the winter, but they return in the spring. Males and females pair up, and then the females will lay a clutch of typically 4, sometimes 3, sometimes 5 eggs. She'll incubate them for a few weeks or a month, and then a few weeks after that, the young will actually leave the box.
I've probably been the one to poke my head in more boxes than anyone over the years, and I never get tired of seeing that new life and realizing that the birds are succeeding in their main task in life, which is to make more birds, and just seeing the young birds at the beginning of their lives and knowing that it's all out there for them and we help make that happen. It's a good feeling.
Kestrel is really such a terrific little bird. It's so emblematic of an important habitat. Of course, it's the emblem of the Kestrel Land Trust, which I serve. And it's really just so great to be able to undertake a conservation activity and see such rapid and tangible signs of success.